Mr. Taru. Now, if you're watching a lot of my videos, you would know that if any day I should be wearing a money shirt, it would be a day that I'm talking about compound interest or money questions. I had a video with a $100 bill t-shirt. Anyway, it used to be one of my favorite topics until the economy went to crap and my 401k plan went down, but I'm sure that's not going to last forever, and these videos will be on the internet for who knows how long. So maybe today, stuff's really high up. I don't know. Anyway, so compound growth, and sometimes with the economy it feels like decay, but compound growth formulas, as far as money are concerned, the two that we have that we're going to deal with today is our final amount of our investment is equal to P, which is principal, that's the starting value, times 1 plus R, that's going to be an interest rate, and we almost always work with interest rates in terms of, or percents in terms of a decimal, so like 5% would be 0.05. N is the number of compounding periods. The examples I'm going to take a look at today are going to be compounded monthly, like most bank accounts are, so N is going to be equal to 12, and T is the number of years. Then, if you have continuous compounding, which is always in the textbooks as money questions, but not many money questions are going to be actually continually compounding every single like split second. That's more for like kind of like bacteria growth, like in nature where things are constantly multiplying on themselves and it's not set by patterns like per day or per month. Okay, so let's take a look at a couple of examples. Let's say that you've got $10,000 and that's going to get compounded monthly. We're using a monthly example because like savings accounts will give you your interest rate back every month, and so it gets redeposited into your account. Unless you pull it out, it starts to grow on that much on that slowly growing base, and therefore it's compounded monthly because again your interest rate comes back at the end of every month. And it's going to earn 7% interest. No banks right now are charging or giving you that much, but maybe it's a stock investment, and we're looking over the long run of 20 years. So we're going to attempt to make 7%, an average of 7% of our money over a 20-year period. Okay, so monthly, 7%, 20 years, how much is your money going to be worth? Well, we're going to use this formula here, which is the final amount of the investment is going to be equal to P, the principal, your initial amount of $10,000, times 1 plus your interest rate of 7% written as a decimal, so 0.07, divided by the number of compounded compounding periods or number of compoundings in a 1-year period, which is monthly, so that's going to be 12, raised to the n 12 times t power, which is number of years. In this case, it'll be 20. Now, this one is a pretty straightforward question because, well, we're just looking for final amount, and the way that it's set up, as long as you have an okay scientific calculator, you'll be able to solve it without the use of logarithms or any kind of fancy ruse. So let's see what happens. It's going to be 10,000. Now, I can't do this math in my head, so I'm going to cheat. And 0.07 divided by 12 plus 1 comes out to be 1.00583. Yes, I've already worked all this out ahead of time. Usually I just do this on the fly. Of course, when I make that sign error, you guys know that. You see the little voice bubble over my problems. 12 times 20 is going to be 240. And this is why you need your scientific calculator, so you can raise this value to the 240th power. We don't want to hit times, this value 240 times. So 1.00583, you always have to do... you need to do your exponents before you multiply, so it's going to be 10,000 times this raised to the 240th power is going to be 4.036, and when you multiply those two together, you find out that if you can maintain that 7% average over a 20-year span, that you're going to have $40,355 and a little bit of change over that 20-year period. So just by not spending this $10,000 and letting it sit over a 20-year period, that'll gain you an additional $30,000 of interest when you didn't have to work for it. All you had to do is not spend this money. And as I remake this recording, the economies have been very, very bad, so 7% seems like maybe an unrealistic value, but in the long trend of 20 years, hopefully that's not going to be too hard to achieve. Even for, you know, 3 or 4 years ago, a bank would give you a CD for 5%. Of course, now it seems like they won't give you anything. But, you know, that's just today's economy. It won't stay like that forever. Okay, let's take a look at another example. Let's take a look at the fact that we want to find out, we want 15,000 to become 25,000. That's what we would like. And we have 10 years in which we need that to happen. So if we have this and we want it to be 25,000, if we have 10 years to allow that money to grow, what interest rate do we need? What will our goal? What do we need to try to achieve to make this $10,000 increase happen over 10 years? Well, again, we're going to compound that monthly, which means that we're going to once again use this first example. And so 25,000 equals 15,000 times 1 plus our interest rate, which we don't know, over the number of compounding periods a year, which is going to be 12 because it's monthly, and that raised to the nth power, 12 times 10. Okay, well, we do not have the variable and the exponent, so again, we're not going to need logarithms. We'll just need a decent scientific calculator. The first thing we're going to do is divide both sides by 15,000. We're going to isolate this part of the expression that has the high exponent. And 25,000 divided by 15,000 is going to be 1.67. That's rounded off, of course. It's 1.6 repeating. Equals 1 plus r over 12 to the 120th power. Now, we're not going to be able to solve for r unless we can get rid of this 120th power. And that involves raising both sides of the equation to the 1 over 120th power, or effectively taking the 120th root of both sides. So again, a scientific calculator at a minimum is going to be needed to do these problems. Of course, if you're watching these videos, you probably at least have a graphing calculator, and certainly a scientific one. So raising both sides to a power of 1 over 120, that's going to set up this power-to-power property. These are going to multiply in the reciprocal, so it becomes 1. And 1.67 raised to the 1 over 120th power becomes 1.0043 equals 1 plus r over 12. We're going to subtract both sides by 1 and get 0.0043 equals r over 12. Multiply both sides by 12 and get an interest rate. If we get at least an interest rate of 0.0516, or 5.16%, then we can achieve the savings goal of getting $15,000 to become $25,000 in a 10-year span. Awesome! Bam! All right, moving on to the next one. Okie dokie. The next example is going to, I'm going to do the continuous compounding first, but I'm going to attempt to do this example twice in the time allotted. Let's say that we want our money to double. And we're going to do continuous compounding. Continuous compounding means we're going to use the PERC formula. And we're going to get, attempt to make 5% on our money. And the question is, how long is that going to take? If you can get continuous compounding, which again is a little bit unrealistic, most bank accounts and investments are going to do monthly compounding, or at the most daily compounding, but at any rate, We want our money to double, continuous compounding, 5%, how long is that going to take? Well, it doesn't matter if you're talking about a dollar becoming $2, $50,000 becoming $100,000, or whatever. Doubling is doubling. So why don't we pick an easy value, and again, because of continuous, we're going to use the PERT formula. And doubling is doubling is doubling. 50,000 becoming 100,000 would make me a lot happier if I had 50,000 to begin with, but it's the same going to be the same amount of the same period of time as making $1 become 2. And so we just want whatever our initial investment is to double. See? No dollar amounts were mentioned, but yet all we have to do is have an initial value and a final amount, a final value that's double whatever you started with. So 1 and 2, why not? E, which is 2.718, interest rate is 5%, so 0.05, and the time period is what we're looking for. Now, when your variable is in the exponent, you are going to probably need logarithms to solve your equation. And since it's base E, we're going to use natural log to save a step. So we don't need to divide by 1 because that's not going to do anything. So 2 equals E to the 0.05t. And to get rid of that base of E, we're going to apply the natural log to both sides. So the natural log of 2 equals the natural log of E to the 0.05t. And that natural log of E is going to cancel out, and this exponent is simply going to fall down. If the natural log did not have the same base as E, which of course it does, but if they did not have a matching base, you could pull the exponent out in front of the logarithm, use that power property of logarithms to bring the variable down out of the exponent and thus be able to solve it. Here, however, this will cancel out. You get natural log of 2 equals 0.05t. Divide both sides by 0.05t, or excuse me, 0.05. And the time period required is going to be 13.8 years. Now, continuous compounding is going to make you money a tiny bit faster than compounding by the month. But I'm going to attempt to do another example, and we are going to end up with the same decimal due to round-off error if I have time. I'm actually not going to have time. I'm just going to write as much as I can. But if we did it monthly, let's see if I can just write it in 2 minutes. Like that. Don't need to worry about the one. Variables in the exponent. So we're going to take the log or natural log of, I wrote natural log in my notes, so natural log of 2 equals the natural log of, this becomes 1.0042 to the 12t power. That becomes natural log of 2 equals 12t, natural log of 1.0042, and natural log of 2 divided by 12 times the natural log of 1.0042 equals t. And if you get that into your calculator properly, with a little bit of round-off error, you're probably going to get 3.8. I'm Mr. True. Bam! That's compound interest. Go do your homework. Thank you for watching and allowing me to help.
You learned some math.